Shepherd of our soul, Shepherd of our soul, Savior of our soul, Lover of our soul. We are on the Lord's side. We will never give up. We are overcome.
But that ye be perfectly joined together in the same mind and in the same judgment. And in the same judgment. That we be perfectly. There is no imperfection in God. We must practice holiness. We must perfectly practice it. It must practice love. We must perfectly practice it. It must practice unity. We must perfectly practice it. Let there be no division. The Bible also told us in Ephesians chapter 4, from verse 1 to 6. Ephesians 4.
Ephesians 1 to 6.
Hallelujah.
I therefore, the prisoner of the Lord, beseech you that ye walk worthy of the vocation wherewith ye are called.
Amen. Hold on, sir. Hold on, sir. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
To I, the prisoner of the Lord, I, that Jesus Christ has kidnapped, I, that Jesus Christ has taken over, has arrested, is beseeching you, is telling you that we should walk worthy of invocation. Of the reason why we are called in this world. Say, with all lowliness, with all humbleness, with all meekness, with long suffering, long suffering. Before, with long suffering. For bearing one another in love. For bearing one another in love. Having patience with each other. No matter what we do to each other. No matter the offense you have committed to each other. Let us learn forgiveness. Let us learn to bear each other's body. Verse 3. Endeavoring to keep the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. In our hearts, let there be peace. In our hearts, let there be peace. And among us, let there be peace. And this can only be done when we are united. The reason why heaven is sustaining the power that is therein is because there is unity between God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Ghost. They are inseparable. God the Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost are inseparable. And when we are also inseparable, no power, no demon can withstand us. Tell me a family who is making progress. I will show you a unified family. Family that husband and wife are speaking the same language. A family that makes progress. For the church to attain the level that God wants to be, all the Christians must be together. The pastors must be together. The church must join force with the pastor. Yes, we are going nowhere. But I pray, God Almighty, will help us to live this together in the name of Jesus Christ. Verse 4 of Ephesians 4. Say, there is one body and one spirit, even as you are called in one hope of your calling. One Lord, one faith, and one baptism. Verse 6, one God and one Father of all, who is above all and through all and in you all. We all are joined together with Jesus Christ for this battle to be won. There's a battle going on in the realm of the Spirit. People are falling into hell every day. But for us not to be a plus in hell, we all must work together in unity, in love, in perfection, in giving to each other. When I cry, you should shed the tears with me. When I am crying in the house, you must know in your house that Apostle Emmanuel is crying. With this, heaven will know that we are together. I'm not talking about the unity in hypocrisy. I'm not talking about we are only united when we're in the church. The unity I'm talking about, what do you think about me when we are not together? How do you see me when I'm not with you? What do you say about me when I'm not with you? It's not when I'm with you. Hey, Apostle Emmanuel, I love you so much. One day, Lord said to me, whatever you will do in the presence of the people, maybe cast out demons, and you to hear the sea, you preach the message, you talk about God. I am not counting that. What I count is what you do in the secret. Do you ask, do you still pray for them when you are in your closet? About these people when you are your their mind. That is what they are saying today. Abundant of iniquity is the heart. Abundant of hatred is in the heart. But they are speaking love in their mouth. That is the generation we have today. The Christian we have today. But the Lord is saying, my children in this church, let the love come from your heart. Let the unity come from your heart. Just as the song says, tell them it's good to love. If you love me, you will not betray me. If you love me, you will not be happy when I'm falling. If you love me, you will not be happy when I lose my job. If you love me, you share the tears with me. And I pray the genuine love that the Lord is talking about, it exists in this church. If you want miracle to be taking place in this church, before the man of God say Holy Ghost, the Lord is already manifesting. We all must be in unity. The Bible told us in Amos 3:3, can two work together unless they agree? The pastor and their sisters cannot work together unless they are in unity. The choir master or choir mistress and the people they are leading cannot work together unless they are in unity. And I pray after this message, the unity the Lord is talking about, we dwell on this mountain, in this church, in the name of Jesus. We all will make to heaven if only we are in unity. If only our knees can be bended to pray for each other. Let us do away with selfishness. Some people are even selfish in prayer. When they are on their knees, all they pray about, my wife, my children, my husband, my family, selfishness. Let us do away with selfishness. Let us get to share what we have together. Let us learn to love one another. And help will be asked in the name of Jesus Christ. Jesus. This is the prayer that Christ prayed while he was on earth. After Christ had done everything, and for the path to go, after he had finished his work on earth, he prayed the prayer in John chapter 17, verse 21. John 17:21. This is the prayer that Christ prayed. And anyone that will stand against prayer, we have Jesus Christ to fight with. When Christ is pronouncing peace, is pronouncing unity, and you are there causing confusion, causing disunity, when you're having all forgiveness, somebody do anything against you in the money, maybe around 5-30 minutes have gone, 1 hour have gone, till evening, you are not forgiven. My sister, my brother, you are digging your grave to hell. You are fighting against the prayer of Jesus Christ. So therefore, must learn forgiveness for us to make heaven. Forgiving easily. John chapter 17. See to 21. Say, never pray I for this only, but for them also which shall believe on me through their word. Verse 21. that they all may be one. That they all may be one. That they all may be one. As thou Father art in me, and I in thee, that they also may be one in us, that the world may believe that thou hast sent me. For the world to know that Jesus is Lord, we must show love. We'll be united. That they may be one. And the pastors and the commissioners may be one. There's one thing I love about Christ so much. When he was on earth, do you know the reason why the Pharisees and the Sadducees did not recognize Jesus Christ? They never knew him. They were looking for who we showed them Jesus. Why? Because Jesus was so much more for himself. He was equal with the disciples. All of them were together in unity. Wherever they are going, you don't see difference between Jesus Christ and disciples. Oh, like today, when pastor is going, one holy shoe, one holy Bible, they differentiate themselves. In the time of Jesus, it was never so. Today, when pastor is going, one will carry the suit. Jesus, in the beginning, it was not so. Jesus Christ was in the same language. When you see Peter, you see Jesus. When you see James, Bartholomew, you see Jesus. He was equal with them. But today, you see the pastors, you see the pastor's wife. They will probably come late. So they say, mommy has come. Mommy, my foot.
Soul, shepherd of a soul.